Jacksonville District UAS team and invasive species team have a history of solving problems and delivering results. Most recently, a need arose to be able to deliver biological control agents over invasive species in areas that could not be reached by historical methods.
Something we're really excited about is we've done on an experimental basis, but we're moving into operational here shortly, is bug releases. So we have, for different invasive species, plant species, there's biological controls that we put on these plants that help manage them. But oftentimes it's very difficult to get to the sites that we need to release these bugs. We can release them on the edges, but if we really want to release them in the middle of the infestations, or in some cases on tops of tree islands and tops of trees, or out in the middle of a marsh somewhere that's very difficult to get to, even by airboat. So what we've done is we've developed release mechanisms, boxes, that you can take the UAV out over, in our case it was for water hyacinth, into a marsh and release the bugs at different locations that we pre-selected, and which would have been really impossible to have done manually.
In these test releases, we use shredded paper instead of the bugs. It allows us to see more easily how the bugs would drop from the boxes.
So the bugs that were initially given to us were Megamellus, and they're used to attack the water hyacinth. They would just eat it up. So, but they're very, very small. They're not going to be heavy, so a lightweight UAS could easily carry them out to these areas and deploy it. Video feedback is really what's important and critical, because you need to make sure that you are over these mats so you can see down and actually know you're getting the target.
For additional information, contact John Lane at the Jacksonville District U.S. Army Corps of Engineers.